let's have discussion. What is exactly residue, dear students? Okay, first of all, I will tell you the define of residue. Then I will tell you the formula of residue and residue theorem also. Okay, then we will approach to the questions. So let me write down, before starting this, let me write down the define of residue. Basically, residue is a coefficient residue. Okay, define of residue. So basically, residue is a coefficient of z minus a to the power minus 1 in the Lorentz series expansion. As you know very well, we discussed the Taylor series. Earlier, we discussed the Taylor series. In the calculus, we discussed the Taylor series. Now, let's have discussion about the Lorentz series. What is Lorentz series and what is the residue? So let me write down, first of all, the Lorentz series, dear students. Here, the Lorentz series is what? Lorentz series. Right, so what it is? Lorentz series, right? So Lorentz series is what? This is fz is equals to a0 plus, now just remember one thing, the residue is the coefficient of Lorentz series expansion, right? In the coefficient of Lorentz series expansion, it is a1 z minus a, a2 z minus a whole square, and so on and so on and so on. Now it's not only this part. Lorentz series having two parts. The first is negative coefficient and the second is positive coefficient also. So it is, and the next is a minus 2 z minus a to the power minus 2, right, plus a minus 1 z minus a to the power minus 1, and so on, right? So this is my Lorentz series. First it will a power minus 1, then it will a minus 2, right? First a power a to the base minus 1, a minus 1 z minus a power minus 1, plus a minus 2 z minus a to the power a minus 2, and so on, right? So this is the Lorentz series, dear students. Okay, now what is residue? The residue is nothing but the coefficient of z minus a to the power minus 1, z minus a to the power minus 1 in the Lorentz series. It means the coefficient of this one, right? The coefficient of z minus a to the power minus 1 means a minus 1. This is the residue, my dear students. Okay, so I will tell you about this one also. So exactly not at all a single question can frame from the Lorentz series, because Lorentz series is not exactly the part of the complex integration. Yes, but residue is the part of the complex integration. So Lorentz series is what? Lorentz series is, it's a simple series expansion. Okay, we can say if fz is analytic within the closed curve C, then we can say fz is equals to a0 plus a1 z minus a, a2 z minus a whole square, a3 z minus a whole cube, and so on. And it will be a minus 1 z minus a power minus 1, a minus 2 z minus a power minus 2, and so on, right? So this is my Lorentz series. Okay, now let me write down the define of residue also. So the define, I was writing the define, so let me write down here the define. Okay, let me write down define here. So define, as I already told you about the Lorentz series, now let me write down the definition of residue. So the definition is, residue is the coefficient of, we can say, the coefficient of z minus a power minus 1, the coefficient of z minus a to the power minus 1 in the Lorentz series expansion, z minus 1 in the Lorentz series expansion, coefficient of z minus a to the power minus 1 in the expansion of, the coefficient of z minus a to the power minus 1 in the Lorentz series expansion of fz is called the residue, right? As I already told you there, that was my residue. So it means we can write down here, in the Lorentz series expansion of fz, thus in the Lorentz series expansion, expansion of fz, okay, around z is equals to a, you can say we are expanding here, z is equals to a only, right? So around z is equals to a, we can say, right? So around z is equals to a, that is fz is equals to, this is my Lorentz series only, a0 plus a1 z minus a power 1, a2 z minus a power minus 2, and so on, a minus 1 z minus a power minus 1, a minus 2 z minus a power minus 2, and so on, right? So the residue of fz at z is equals to a is a inverse. So the residue of fz, the residue of fz, the residue of fz at z is equals to a is a minus 1. So as we already told, the coefficient of z minus a power minus 1, so the coefficient is this one only, so that's why a power a minus 1 is my residue. Now this is a basic thing about residue, so definitely there will be no defined can ask in the GATE examination, but how we approach a residue, right? Let's have discussion how we can find the value of the residue, how we will approach the residue. So residue is always equals to, if you want to write down from here, you can say residue of f of a is equals to 1 by 2 pi iota into fz dz, right? You can write down just like this. Residue of f of a is equals to 1 by 2 pi iota. Residue of f of a is equals to, yes, 1 by 2 pi iota into fz. Give me 1 minute. Yes, now. So what I was talking about, residue of f of a is equals to 1 by 2 pi iota into fz dz. This is the residue only, guys. Okay, so we can approach for residue. If you want to write down in this form, you can write down here also. So actually the question can frame in this form only, because in the question it's not only residue. In the question we have to find the complex integration. So it's given in the question to find the value of close integration cfz dz. So we can respond for that 2 pi iota into residue of f of a. 2 pi iota into residue of f of a. Now the thing is how we will find the residue, how we will find the value of the residue. Okay, so let me show you how to find the residue. There are two methods to find the residue. This is the first one. Okay, if we have a simple pole, it actually depends on the pole or the category of pole. If we have a simple pole, means single order pole, 1 degree pole, right, at z is equals to a, then the residue of f of a is always is equals to limit z tends to a z minus a, limit z tends to a z minus a into fz. It's always like this, limit z tends to a z minus a into fz. It will be my simple pole. Okay, now if we have, it's only and only for simple pole or single order pole. If we have repeated pole, means suppose we have z is equals to a 3 times. Okay, so if we have repeated poles at z is equals to a of order, and it can be of any order, it can be of order 2, 3, 4, 5, means more than one order. Clear? So then the residue will be, residue of f of a is equals to 1 by n minus 1 factorial, limit z tends to a. Here we have to find the derivative. Here we have to find the derivative. So limit z tends to a, derivative means dn minus 1 by dz n minus 1 z minus a power n into fz. Clear? So for the single order pole we will approach like this. For the more than one order pole, okay, for the repeating pole we will approach just like this. I think it's clear. Let me tell you one more time. The residue, the meaning of the word residue is nothing but the expansion of Lorentz series in the coefficient of z minus a to the power minus 1 in the expansion of Lorentz series. okay, somewhere we use directly, if we have the expansion, if we have a question in the form of series, we can directly approach with this one. If we have somewhere the series at z minus 1 power minus 1 and we have coefficient of that one, so directly we can approach. But if we are not able to find the expansion each and every time, then how we will approach? So that's why we have the method to find the residue. This is the first method when we have single order pole. Okay, when we have simple pole or the single order pole, the residue will be limit z tends to a, z minus a into fz. When we have double order pole, the residue, double order means more than one order pole, okay, nth order pole, 1 by n minus 1 factorial d, limit z tends to a, dn minus 1 by dz n minus 1, z minus a to the power n and fz. Clear, guys? Right? Now, this is called the residue. Now, you can ask, ma'am, how we use the residue theorem. Ultimately, residue theorem is nothing but the sum of all the residues. So, what about the residue theorem? Residue theorem is ultimately this one only. Means, close integration C fz dz. In the residue theorem, we will always find the value of the complex integration only. So, residue theorem used to apply or used to approach the complex integration questions only, right? So, it will be close integration C fz dz. It will be 2 pi iota into sum of all the residues. So, you can write down here 2 pi iota into sum of all given residues. Okay, sum of all given residues. Is it clear, guys? Right, residue. Is it clear? Okay, we can easily approach this one. Now here, the one important thing you have to understand that whenever we have to find the close integration C, fz, dz, it should be, okay, whatever the residue you find, that residue or that pole have to lie inside the closed curve. If that is inside the closed curve, then only we will consider the residue of that at that particular point only. Okay, I will show you questions. Don't worry for that. Done, guys? Clear? So this is called the residue theorem, or this is the Cauchy's residue theorem. The name of this theorem is Cauchy's residue theorem. Clear? It's clear. It's Cauchy's residue theorem. Done? Okay.